This is Daniel Gabriel speaking from The Big Picture. I'm here in Yerevan, Armenia. We're here at the Global Forum Against the Crime of Genocide, 22nd to the 24th of April. We've been interviewing quite a few people inside, a lot of the professors, ministers, other parliamentarians, about the genocide issue against the Armenians, the Greeks, and the Aramean Syriacs. As you can see, quite a few people here at the forum. There's a lot of ministers here, a lot of politicians, and other scholars, professors, historians. It's been a great event by the Armenians, and Yerevan is an absolute magical place, really an inspiration to the Aramean people. So, chat to you soon. I'm here in beautiful Yerevan, Armenia. I'm here actually speaking to Arman Akopian, who is a diplomat and a scholar here in Armenia. Welcome to the show, and thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
I wanted to talk to you because you have just, of course, written this book here, which I'll show to the, if I can get this around here like this. This is your most recent publication, which I'll ask you about in a moment. And of course, you also have this book here as well, which I have upside down. This book here is used in your course, as I understand, because you're also a lecturer at the university on Syriac Aramaic, where you also teach Syriac.
Yes, technical works as well. So this connection has been very strong. And also, let me mention that when the Armenian alphabet was created at the beginning of the 4th century, a part of the process took place in Edessa, in the Syriac-Aramean milieu, if you can say so. And because of that rich culture and that rich literary translation that existed in that city with its rich archives and libraries, so it was a perfect place for the Armenian scholars who were involved in the creation of the alphabet to spend time in Edessa. And very safely assume that we're in very close contact with Syriacs in the process of creation of the alphabet.
Some of the other things that you also speak about in your book is about the terminology of Asuri, which is, as we would know it, as the Arameans would know it, is the direct translation to the Arameans or the Syrian Christians. What is your perception of that definition of Asuri? And how often is it? It's used here in Armenia, just to be clear. It's used here in Armenia to describe a certain group of people. But the term, because of course we've just been here in Armenia at the Global Forum for the Crime Against Genocide, and during the whole conference, basically, there was a reference to the Aramean genocide, the Syriac genocide, as being an Assyrian. We kept on referring to Assyrianism. There seems to be a confusion of terminology, doesn't there? Because Asuri does not mean Assyrian.
Well, in the Armenian languages, there is very established terminology which goes back to at least 5th century. And in the Armenian historians, in medieval historians and modern historians, they're very clearly distinguished between Asuri and Asuristanci. Asuri being the Armenian equivalent of the classical Syriac term Suriaya, which was adopted after the Arameans, you know, this history, they adopted Christianity, and since the name Aramean became equivalent to pagan, so they switched to Suriaya. And in Armenian tradition, the Asuri was the equivalent of Suriaya. When we read our medieval historians like Moses of Koren, it becomes very obvious for him existed two separate peoples, Syriacs, whom we call Asuri, and ancient Assyrians were called Asorestanci. And this is the tradition that exists in Armenian historical science up to these days. If you take the Armenian encyclopedia and you read the article about the Asuris, the first line that says the Asuris are the descendants of Arameans. Or if you read, for example, we have a very interesting book on Armenian-Syria cultural exchanges by Hayek Melkonian, very famous historian, very famous book. He says the same thing, that Asuris are part of the Aramean people. So in Armenian terminology, there is no confusion. Of course, other people in the streets may confuse Asuri with Asuristanci because sound alike. But this distinction exists in our historiography.
But they don't use the terminology orthoreia.
The term used here in Armenia, of what I hear all the time, it's surae. So they call themselves mostly surae. Naturae is, that's a more or less artificial term that was introduced in the 19th century. Sometimes.
Thank you so much, Mr. Kopian. I really thank you for your time.
Thank you for inviting me.